guys, it's Weta here. Welcome back to Weta's World. If you're new here, make sure you subscribe. I wanted to do a full face of first impressions. There's gonna be like three parts to this video. Third part of the video is gonna be about like complexion makeup and that kind of thing. I have a old but new kind of favorite for you guys. It's a foundation that I've got in the past that I did like in the past. I have nothing against it. They've just increased their shade range, and so I had the lightest shade before, and now I have the lightest shade now, and I will compare the two. Possibly do like one on one side of my face, one on the other, so we can really see if there's a difference. That's like an idea that I have, but at the same time, like, all my lighting already comes from my left side of the room, so I don't feel like that would be a completely fair shot for it. I'm thinking maybe to put it on all of my face, but I do want to show you guys the swatches of both, and then I'll finish the look with a new lip product. Of course, like bronzing and highlight, but those are not new products. So here I have them in my hands. I haven't told you yet what product I'm talking about. I'm talking about the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless kind of foundation. So the one that I had before was 110 Porcelain. I believe that's still a shade in their shade range, but now there are two lighter colors than that, like a number 105. I think it's like fair beige or something like that, and then I have 102 Fair Porcelain. So this is the lightest one in the whole range. When you look at them side by side, they look basically the same. This one just looks a teeny bit lighter, which it's supposed to be. I'm gonna show you a swatch of them side by side. I'm gonna swatch it on me how I would normally swatch anybody. So keep in mind, this is number 110. So that's on there. And then I'm gonna put 102 right next to it. And this one, I can instantly tell based on that that it is wider. Like, look at that. I'm gonna put this all over my face. The 110 looks a lot more peachy and orange, and that's really like a common problem that I have with the lightest shade of like many foundation ranges. So I'm so excited that they expanded it both on this end and the other end. Like, I think, like, I might have tweeted about it, how like we need like more shades. Like, these people in the middle, they're so lucky like right now that the industry is focusing on them and wanting their money, but you know, like, our money's just as green too. Like, on the other side, it's much more important like that we get representation there, because there are a lot more brands that do cater to the lighter shades, even if they don't have the lightest ones, you know what I mean? So we gotta keep that in mind. For me, with all the sun damage that I have this summer, obviously this color is not ideal on my forehead, but definitely in the winter time I can like pull this shade off effortlessly. And like, the thing too with too light foundation, you can warm it up so easily with bronzer and contour that it's really not even like a big deal. It's like when your foundation is darker than your skin, that's where it can look really odd, and there's not much you can do about it. From what I can see, like in the screen, I think I'm blended, but I'm gonna make sure. And then I'm gonna set powder. I'm just gonna like finish up my face. I'll tell you how I did it in just a moment. So I finished up blending, because my blending was so streaky, it was out of control. I finished blending it. I tried like stippling it, and it felt like I had a lot of pores showing. The thing about this foundation and my skin type, it's supposed to be for normal to like oily skin, the matte and whatever, matte and poreless version, because it's supposed to like be oil minimizing, right? I have very dry skin, so it didn't really look like ideal for my personal skin type. But with powder over it, it really, like, I don't know how that doesn't even make sense, because I am a dry skin kind of type. You would think that powder would even make it worse, but it really just like made everything look like it had like a filter on it, just a little bit more seamless, a little less pores. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do bronzer, blush, highlight off camera, and then I'll do lips to try out a lip product. Okay, hi guys! I just finished up like my bronzer, blush, and highlight, and before I set, I have to do my lips. So I have the Lorac LA Alter Ego Hydrating Lip Stain. And I haven't used a lip stain for like shit years. And stains are not like what they used to be. Like they used to be like a globby, glossy kind of like liquidish kind of thing. Like I don't know how to describe it. But this looks like a lipstick. It's tall. And it's flat, so I don't understand it. I guess let's swatch it. Oh, that's bright. So I have with me a lip liner that I thought would go with it. I want to swatch that too to see if it's true. I guess the two.
I think I can make that work. So
there's no way that I can freaking do this right on camera. Like, if you know me, you know I'm not precise with my makeup at all. You could tell. Like, give me a few minutes. I'll come back when I have the product on my lips and I'll tell you what I think.
Going back, I just
applied those two lip products. I'm about to set my face. For some reason, my eye got all watery. I don't know why. It's pissing me off. The nice thing about when I first started applying this lip stain, it applied like a lipstick. I don't know why it's flat topped. That's kind of really hard for me to make a precise shape. Like I had to do most of my like lip shaping with this pencil, so that was challenging. It has a really nice feel on the lip, like very buttery, moisturizing feel, and it smells really good too. That's all of the products that I wanted to review. I liked some of them more than others. Like the mascara was no go. One of the liners was okay. The other one was unusable. The lip was nice. The foundation was nice.
So this is the final look with
all my first impressions. We had some hard times in this video, but we like overcame it and like came out with a full face of makeup. I make a lot of other kinds of videos. I do vlog. I make travel videos and I have a couple really cool trips that I've vlogged before. So check those out if you haven't already. Follow me on Snapchat, Instagram, and Twitter, all at Girl With The Legs. Make sure to like this video down below. Subscribe to this channel called Wet Ass World. And I'll see you next time. Bye!